It's been another week. Here we are, back in the office. We've been out in the car a lot lately, and in Kauai, the car in Kauai. This is Eliza. She's my wife.
You've met me.
You know her from the show Platoon of Power Squadron. This is just a rambly update, so if you're not looking for that, go take a bath. That sounds nice.
It does sound nice.
Okay, first thing I want to talk to you about today is Dan Trachtenberg, man. Dan Trachtenberg. You go. So this guy, okay, first link in the dupes, top link in the dupes is gonna be his Portal fan film short that he made. It's awesome. He put it up on YouTube, it got a gajillion hits, and everyone's talking about Dan Trachtenberg and his awesome Portal fan film. Yesterday, was it yesterday or the day before? Tommy Knockers, knocking on the door. No, it was, was it yesterday? When did I tweet that tweet? Let's see. Yeah. Okay, so it was yesterday. Yesterday, they dropped the trailer and the poster for the next Bad Robot release, 10 Cloverfield Lane. And that thing looks awesome. Directed by Dan Trachtenberg, he of the YouTube Portal short. That's just amazing. It's got Mary Elizabeth Winstead from Scott Pilgrim. It's got John effing Goodman. He's the best. And the trailer could not be better. That trailer is so good. That song use mixed with all the other sounds, the building sounds. Oh my, I love it. So that guy, YouTube, feature film with Bad Robot. Oh, that is so great. Watch the Portal short, watch that trailer. I'm one of the guys, I really liked the first Cloverfield. I know a lot of people are like, found footage monster movie, blah, 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 blah. Not me. I went to that thing at a matinee the day it came out, and I loved it. It's my favorite found footage movie because it's a found footage movie that they actually put a lot of effort into making it look found footage. They put a lot of money behind it, and that makes me appreciate the fact that found footage is not just a way to make it cheaper, it actually serves the story they're trying to tell. But thankfully, just like Blair Witch 2 Book of Shadows, they're going not found footage with the second one, which I think is definitely the right choice. I thought it was the right choice for Blair Witch 2 as well, although that's a very maligned film. Eliza and I were just listening to Script Notes Podcast. Craig Mazin was railing that there's no software that can predict what's going to make a movie succeed. You know, there's all these things where people are like, I have the algorithm, I have the science behind, you know, to make people feel confident in spending the money on a studio movie. Based on this formula and these things we've seen before, this movie will make its money back. You know, that's what studio executives are looking for. That's all they're looking for, is not just a return on investment, but a profit, a huge profit on investment, which worked out for Disney with this Force Awakens business. Anyway, Craig Mazin was like, you can't predict, no matter what, you can't predict what's going to be successful. Even remaking a successful property is not going to be a success. We've seen that before with quite a few movies, actually. He was like, that's not how this business works. He was like, you need to be the one setting a trend. That's when you know you have something special, is when you have something that hasn't been done before. That's what's going to get a lot of attention. I agree with that sentiment a lot. Like, I haven't seen this before. This is an interesting approach to an old story, but it's something we haven't seen before, you know? Because every story's old. It doesn't matter. Eliza and I were talking about it, and it's one of those things where, like, a lot of business industries are about finding a hole. There's something that people need that they don't have. And they manufacture that thing, and because people didn't know they even needed it, but now they realize how useful it is, everybody buys that thing and you make a lot of money. That's how it works. Except in this industry, where you find something that people haven't seen before, executives are not going to be like, I've never seen that work before. So in the movie industry, it's the opposite model. You're like, show me something that I've already seen be successful. That's what I'm going to put my money into. And that's why a lot of people feel that the industry is stagnating, especially from a creative standpoint. Movies especially, because movies are getting harder and harder to make money back on because of all of the avenues. Like streaming, it's harder to make a bunch of money back as opposed to like Blu-ray and DVD sales. So it's just kind of thinning out the herd there, and it's making it harder to make a movie if it's not a like remake of Star Wars, or, you know, it's not a remake, but if it's not a continuation of Star Wars, or if it's not the next Star Trek movie, or if it's not the next Marvel movie, if it doesn't have a whole huge ton of computer effects and a budget of like just over $100 million or more, it's not worth it for a studio most of the time. That's why a lot of smaller independent companies are the ones making the movies that you're hearing about now. A24, Ex Machina, The Witch, Room, these guys, they're small company, and they are just killing it right now. And I also love their logo a lot. That's it for today, guys. A lot of info. Go Dan Trachtenberg, go. Awesome. That trailer, I just keep thinking about it. I watched it over and over again. I'm very excited. Very excited about that movie. That's the Pops logo. Hope you guys have a good one. I have a read-through tonight with the cast, so we're going to do a read-through of episode 10, and I'll have some footage of that maybe next week. So I'll see you guys around. Hope you have a good one.